Hello, and thank you for buying the Stephen Garryo home videotape. If you're shocked by nudity and explicit sexual contact, then take this tape back to the store now.
But nudity is what Steve Garligula is all about. Isn't that the name of this?
What?
Steve Garligula.
Oh, like Caligula.
Get it?
That's right. So take off your shirt, even though I love you in that shirt, and let's get started. Oh, just kidding. No nudity in this. Are you kidding?
No, bring the family back.
Come on back. Come on back into the living room. Come on back. What you're about to see is...
we'll shock you. No, we already did that.
It's an attempt by us to take the video snippets that we have laying around in our homes and make some extra money off them.
We had Jim Henson and the Snippets help us with this.
And, no, we're not doing this for money. We're doing this for art. Because we owe a guy named Art a lot of money. What you will see in the next hour...
will shock you. I can't stop. Sorry, I can't.
Yeah, it'll shock you because you'll see a much more slender, much happier Steve Dahl, a Garry Meier in various stages of perm and beard.
Perm or temp, we don't know.
And that's what you'll see.
Watch for the hair color changes on this dude.
Yeah, I'm getting grayer. I'm very unhappy.
He goes from a blue-black to like a Phil, well, like Phil Donahue.
Yeah. I mean, I got into this business originally because, you know, I loved the art form. And now, you know, it's strictly money for me. That's why we're doing this tape. You know, we've got these pieces of tape laying around. We own the rights to them. What the hell? Somebody will buy the tape, right? It's only 1995, so here it is. This is from our first show, this first snippet. We did it in 1979.
Right.
And I love you in a beard. I'm still unhappy that you shaved it off. And I love seeing him in the beard. And look for me without the horrible bags under my eyes. This is from our show, Not for Midgets Only.
Enjoy.
Hi, I'm Steve Dahl. And right about now, you're probably wondering to yourself, or maybe even out loud, what the hell is this guy doing on TV? What sort of responsible station management would allow a bozo like him on their airwaves? Who's to blame for this anyway? Let us not fix the blame on any one person. Let's just say that this show is merely the culmination of months of research. Research into the private lives of the executives here at Channel 5. I originally approached the management here back in August. I told them I had this great idea for a half-hour Steve Dahl special. And they told me, and I'm quoting now, the only way you'll get a show on this station is by blackmail. So, blackmail it was. Fortunately, I've always had an interest in photography and filmmaking. As a matter of fact, some of the stuff was so good, like this shot here of the program director in a bathtub filled with cottage cheese and a dead goat. By the way, this shot was taken right before he had the naked Girl Scout troop brought in. Some of the stuff was so good, the management here has graciously decided to make this an hour-long show. Isn't that great? I hope you have as much fun watching it as I had getting it on the air.
It's Steve Dahl, not for Midgets Only, starring Steve Dahl. With me, Garry Meier. Featuring a special musical appearance by The Who.
This dude's sick of parties.
I think the $10 a person we gave him for the standing ovation at the end of the song was worth it,
don't
you
think? It worked. You got it.
Hey, welcome to our show. We're really glad to have you here. I can't believe we're on TV. We're going to have some fun. We got The Who coming up, not live in the studio, but on tape because we didn't want you to get trampled. We got the lady from Tinley Park stopping by tonight.
Oh, yeah. That reminds me. Your mother just called from California.
Was she drunk?
She was, but she said, I hope he washed and combed his hair for
this.
Yeah,
I think I did. You love it? Is it
nice,
super? Come
nice
on.
Shine on that.
Thank you. My parents can't get the show in California. They live in Los Angeles, but they're both alcoholics, and they think they can. So they're watching Channel 5 right now in Southern California, and they probably think it's me.
Having a good time.
Isn't he cute? Oh, isn't he cute? Too bad about your parents dying in that head-on collision last night. I'm sure they would have loved the show, too, but what can you do?
You're so compassionate.
Listen, we'll be back in a couple of seconds. We're going to have some fun, so stick with us and wake up!
Yeah.
Garry and I are on the
the road in Garry's Winnebago. Sort of like Hope and Crosby, except we're not on the road to Mandalay. We're on the road to social relevance.
Oh, wow.
Oh, man, be cool. Put your hands back on the wheel there. We're going to be traveling around the Chicagoland area today asking a probing, hard-hitting, socially relevant question. A question that deals explicitly with the human experience. Some may be offended by the explicitness of this question, but we feel it's a question whose time has come. Excuse us. Hi.
Hi.
We're Steve Dahl and Garry Meier from Not For Midgets Only. We're on the road. How are you?
Okay, how are you?
Great. What's your name?
Sandy.
Hi, Sandy. Yeah. This week we're asking people who work in photomats where they go to the bathroom. You don't have one in here, do you?
No, we don't. We go into the open pantry over there.
Oh, is it nice in there? Is it clean?
Yeah, it's clean.
They never run out of toilet paper or soap or anything?
No.
So actually, everything's cool. It works out okay. For a long time, Garry and I felt sorry for people that work in photomats because we thought maybe they had to hold it all day or something.
No.
Oh, that's good. Okay, well, thank
Come
you.
On. When you gotta go, you gotta go, right?
Yeah, sure. Okay, well, thank you very much. Merry Christmas.
You too.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
Mary.
I'm Steve Dahl. That's Garry Meier. We're on the road for Not For Midgets Only, and we have a very probing question to ask you.
Okay.
Are you ready for it?
Yeah.
When you're working here, where do you go to the bathroom?
In the laundromat.
Just anywhere in the laundromat?
There's a bathroom in the laundromat.
They don't care if you use it or anything?
No.
No, and is it always clean and well stocked?
Well, yeah, I guess.
Good enough, huh? Hi. We're not burglars or anything. It's cool. Oh, we're getting the full open on this one. Wow. Complex. You must not have very many people come here if it's that closed up. What's your name?
Teresa.
I'm Steve Dahl. I'm sorry, I didn't hear your last name.
Hernandez.
Oh, hi. I'm Steve Dahl. This is Garry Meier. We're on the road for Not For Midgets Only, and we have a question for you. When you have to go to the bathroom, where do you go? There's no bathroom in this little thing, is there?
No, most people go over to the laundromat or someplace else.
The laundromat. Now, is that a coin-operated toilet in there, like the washing machines?
I don't know. I've never been in there.
And you never have to go to the bathroom at work? Never? Not even one time? Ever?
Not here. I haven't had to go.
How long is your shift?
About 4.5 hours.
You mean in 4.5 hours you'd never have to go to the bathroom once? You're sick. See a doctor.
Very good.
So long. Probing, socially relevant, extremely meaningful, hard-hitting. I think so. Steve Dahl and Garry Meier on the road in Garry's Winnebago for Not For Midgets Only.
What the H-E double hockey sticks are you doing?
What you're about to see might shock you. Yes, we actually won an Emmy Award. I know, I was shocked by it. And not for that last television show that you just saw snippets of, understandably so. We won an Emmy for a program entitled Greetings from Graceland about Elvis Presley. Mm-hmm. And all of the hoopla, can I use a television term? Hoopla?
That's a television term?
Surrounding his death. No, that's not right. That's not what it was about. It was about all of the souvenir stands around his house.
That's what it was about.
That's what it was about. And we tried to get the clearance from the television station that we produced it for to show you a snippet, but they were so embarrassed by the show, even though we won an Emmy for it. You know how TV executives are. Well, maybe you don't. Let me tell you, they're assholes.
Whoa.
Okay?
Whoa.
Did that shock you?
Salty language here.
We promised you something shocking, and okay?
We're delivering.
So, the general manager of the station would not release even one snippet of the show for us to show
not
you because
one.
He felt it was so embarrassing. But they ran it because they spent $18,000 on it. So what
is
I do...
Is your arm getting tired yet?
Yes, it is. Can I put it back down here where I like it?
Yeah, I'll bet you do.
You know, I used to be in the band in high school and I would hold the flag.
What was his name?
The flag.
I thought you held him in the shower.
So, I do have some videotape of me French kissing Elvis's dog.
This may shock you.
Yeah, actually it might, but at least this has something to do with Elvis. So here it is now.
Oh, no. You don't know where Steve's tongue has been.
Hello.
No. That's a good one.
Time once again for dog ventriloquism. This is a real dog. This is a fake dog. Speak.
Speak.
Spud.
Speak. Speak.
Bud, speak! It's very hard for dogs to do ventriloquism, and a lot of times they have to lay down to conserve their energy. Speak!
Bud, speak! Speak! Speak!
Look at that. She can lick, she licks, and speaks at the same time. Speak! 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 Do we have a glass of water or something she could drink? Now this is utterly fascinating. She can drink water and still make the dummy dog bark. Speak!
Speak! Speak! Speak! Speak! Spud, speak! Speak! Speak!
Fascinating. Fascinating dog ventriloquism. I like to be able to relate to my dogs, so I make them smoke a lot of dope and listen to a lot of rock music, and it makes them as weird as I am. I start the indoctrination when they're puppies.
I can't explain what's going on here. No, but it's, I gotta go vomit, in fact. I need to show this to, like, adults and children of all ages. I mean, he doesn't care. Well, listen, when do you want to come over?
I don't care.
He doesn't care. Obviously, about what he's doing, he doesn't care.
Not yet. Not yet. This is colder.
But.
Dog's going to lick his toes on camera. Yeah, this is mass appeal. And I don't know what else to tell you.
Okay.
He owes you money. Were you here last time? This is why the bed's all messed up. Okay. Listen, Don, I don't know what to tell. I mean, you know better than I don't know what to tell you.
All right, ready?
This is Don.
Spud, get up here. Come on.
Call back in about 20 minutes. Okay.
Spud, thanks. Come here. Come on up here. Clean my feet for me, Spud. Come on. One, two, Spud, Spud! Hey, you forgot, hey, Spud! Spud, hey.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh. Ooh, Spud. Ooh.
You have to realize his wife's been gone for over 3 weeks.
Ooh. Spud, there's more, come on, they're still dirty. Oh, yeah, there's a little dirt right there. Ooh. Ah. Ooh.
You're forgetting there's a camera here. Sucks then.
Hey, Garry.
Yeah.
Got any peanut butter?
Hungry? Think you've had enough.
I'm not going to eat it. I thought maybe you might like a little snack, a little peanut butter and jam sandwich.
I think your dog is the perfect
toe jam, that is. Or if you'd like it without the peanut butter, there's some moist little pockets of lint in there.
I think I'll pass.
Okay.
There must be about 4 grams
in
here.
Hey, that's where I keep my stash in the bottom of my Emmy. Who would look there?
Would you like this taken out to your car and welded to the hood, like I did with mine?
You're so Negro. What am I doing? I should be... Hey, save this stuff. It's like gold in the 80s. Hey!
That's prop stuff.
For later.
Man, I really want to talk now. Let's talk.
Yeah, let's rap. Okay, screw the snippets. We're just going to rap. Okay, now the next show we're going to show you was our third project. The second project, of course, we couldn't show you because the television station that showed it originally won't release it because it's too embarrassing. And even though we won an Emmy, they still say it's too embarrassing. It was the only Emmy they won that year. What can I tell you? It's a fucked up business. This third show...
Watch your language.
Does that shock you?
Sometimes.
Fucked up. Okay? Fucked up. Okay, bring the kids back into the room. Oh, my God. We never told them to leave.
Oh,
sorry. This show was done in a house, a ranch house in Joliet, Illinois. It was only on for a month. We'll tell you why it was canceled later. Whereas, a Good Morning America tries to make a studio look like a home. We tried to make a home look like a studio.
And they try to make David Hartman look like a human being.
Right. I have some props I brought, you know, to kind of spice up these intros. Could you hold these for me?
Now you look just like David Hartman. That's what we're trying to tell you.
You mean Darth Hartman.
Darth Hartman. Now what?
Well,
this is relevant to the piece, right?
No. I just wanted to wear this.
The helmet,
I think I look good in this. Yes, well, one of the bits that they're going to see from It's Too Early is the Joliet 500, which was a go-kart race that we had on Memorial Day. Get it? We're very clever. So here are some snippets from our third show, which wasn't even nominated for an Emmy Award.
Certainly not an Academy Award.
Must be the cocaine. Yeah, as a matter of fact, well, you have to nominate yourself, and we nominated ourselves, but they rejected the entry. It didn't even get to the nomination stage. So what can I tell you? So here are some snippets from It's Too Early.
Something I wrote.
We don't need no stinking badges. None of this is done with Somos los mariachis, los caporales de Chicago, Illinois. Es muy temprano. Es too early in the morning.
Es muy temprano.
I guess it's too early.
Good morning, Steve and Garry. This is Blasta, the polka queen, and it's too early.
If Steve go, he gon' make it! You got it? I'll tell you like this. Ain't no time to be bull driving. Ain't no time to be crazy. Just be that old tack.
Before we bring Mike out, let me read something from the local Kenosha paper concerning his winning the Mr. Kenosha title. His winning Mr. Roboto routine, made up of the jerky controlled movements of a machine, is his expression of how the blue-collar worker is controlled by everything else, he explained after the program. Quote, he can only do so much. He can only move so far. I don't know. I'm a little bit...
I guess you can say I'm tearing up. That was so beautiful. We're not laughing at you. We're laughing with you.
For you. Because you can't laugh as a mime.
You're a mime.
Okay. Let's get right to it. I can't wait any longer.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, there he is.
Please welcome Mr. Kenosha and Mr. Roboto. Because he can't. Dan, I'm going to come over there and wring your little puny neck in about 1 minute. Now knock it off.
Who broke wind? Woo!
Idiot in charge of pyrotechnics. He is the biggest idiot in the world. There's no way that guy should be running around out here with a match or whatever it is he's using to light. I mean, he was pointing those things right at us.
It's a Porsche, man. It's a theme show. It's a Gandhi theme.
It's a tribute to Gandhi.
It's on. All right. Our like next guest sick. Is Mr. Tony Malone, who's written a book called
How to Talk Nice. Yeah, but you can't see the garlic press there.
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 There we go.
How to Talk Nice.
You can't see Tony either. Take
come on
one.
Over here, Tony.
Let me come. Yeah.
Come on.
Hey, Luigi, what's happening?
Hey, come va bene.
There we go.
This guy, taught me how to talk Italian.
Let's talk Italian.
Also, he taught me how to make the sausage and paper shit.
Sausage and papers.
It's really amazing what you can do with this material. I taught your band members, just in a matter of a few minutes, each how to say a sentence in Italian-American. By the way, I am professor of Italian-American linguistics at Triton College.
Over by Triton, over by Maywood over there.
It's over by the Sausage Time Naples over there. All right, so we'll start.
You guys know some phrases?
Yeah, we did terrific.
Good.
Roman, hit it.
Hey, Dahl, sit down by the Davenport, nice.
It's easy.
Come on, you guys.
Greg dressed for the occasion.
Right.
Well, he's got a tablecloth on.
Hey, Dahl, I got a used Monty for $3,000.
I used what? Monty?
I used Monty.
Hey, Carlo?
A Monte Carlo. It's actually more clash than a Trans Am. Especially in a nice rich color. Brown. Nice rich.
For $3,000.
But not a shy line. Not a shy line is like a Mark.
Or a Mark V. You start out with a Mark III. Now it's up to Mark V. The other thing is, it's Italian day. That's not camera three. It's camera tree. So from now on, it's tree. Camera tree.
Camera tree.
Camera tree.
You should hear it when we go over to his house and we get drunk and he swears in Italian.
Oh,
we
can't, gosh.
Obviously, we can't do that today.
Okay, Johnny.
Hey, Dahl, that's a nice strange name itself.
Did you notice the itself at the end
of
the
shelf.
Sentence? It's an important rule to remember.
Mm-hmm. Ed?
Hey, Meier, nice fake shirt.
Nice
fake shirt.
Fake.
No collar. Fake collar. Right?
Are you getting? Yeah, you get his face when he talks.
Well, this.
We're getting it.
It's all in the book here.
Yeah.
I actually have. There's actually inflections that are.
Now, are we doing the Maywood or the Elmwood Park dialect today?
No, it's not Maywood. It's Melrose Elmwood. Elmwood Park.
Maywood. What's Maywood? That's a racetrack. Get confused. Okay, you got
in Little Italy, which extends now down north on Harlem to about Belmont.
So we're doing
it's
the
a high line
part.
Area.
Well, what yesterday? What we
Melrose Park.
Melrose. Right. I was missing. Okay, right. We're doing. Are we doing Elmwood?
Elmwood. So there's slight differences, but imperceptible differences.
All right. So
but not to the trained ear. Not to your trained ear. I'm sure.
For example, in Melrose. In Melrose, to look cool, you don't even have to say anything. All you got to do is this. That's it. That's all you gotta do. If you walk down Lake Street,
do it again.
In Melrose Park, I mean, you get barraged by the thousands. All you gotta do. All you gotta do is this. That's it. I've seen it. It's amazing. It's amazing.
Tony, do that real tight to camera three.
Camera three. Where's it at?
Raise your hand.
The one that's just two on it.
Yeah.
You think it was made in Italy or something. Camera three. Now watch. Everybody watch, because this will get you brides. It takes years to do that.
Oh, God.
It's all in the book. I talk nice.
The green flag will go
right,
up this
John,
time.
I'm gonna stop talking. I'm gonna turn the race over to my buddy up at the desk, Blind Al Lerner. Blind Al?
Here we are. Thank you, Steve.
Looks like we
the pace
up.
Car is going by.
Looks like
will they get the green?
Not yet. No start yet.
He did not give him the start yet.
But looks like the pace car's pulling off.
The green will come back now. Ladies and gentlemen, here we are in Race Central. The fans have assembled in the infield. We're not sure of the count now. Here come the cars. Here they come. The green flag is up. They are going to hit the start, and the race is underway. The Jolly 50 in front. Gary Meier right on his tail. And we have in the inside pass. And of Teenage Radiation as we go into the first lap. We go behind the house into turn two. Here they come. Oh, Dahl almost spun by. And he goes in the circle there, but they keep it under control. These round effects.
Because.
and four.
Now what?
Well, I'm trying to embody all of what you just saw. Oh my God. Oh, shit in here. If there's a fire in this helmet, I'm dead. Shit. There. I'm trying to embody everything they just with my prop. The helmet, kind of a Darth Vader thing. Mm-hmm. They just saw the Star Wars stuff. Mm-hmm. The race. The Italian thing. Huh? Look at that. Look at that. Can you see that? Does that show up on television? Does that show up nice? Look at that.
Like touching it much or what?
Trying to make it bigger.
That'll require surgery, don't you think?
I'm sure my wife would. And this is why the show was canceled. Because we did it from 7 to 9 a.m. Chicago time every morning, Monday through Friday, for a month. And the last show, we didn't know it was the last show at the time, I decided to open the show from the toilet. It was 7 a.m. That's usually what I'm doing at 7 a.m. I mean, they do it on Hill Street Blues all the time. But the guy who owned the station didn't like it, and that was it.
I said I would keep my beard as long as we had that TV show.
Right.
And so much for that.
Here. So now you'll have a beard during these segments, but not during the video segments. After It's Too Early, we got into the home video market, and the first thing we put out was my workout tape, my Steve Dahl 20-second workout tape.
Is this it?
No, this is the Jane Fonda
tape. Just kidding.
Hers is like 20 minutes, okay? I say you can stay in shape by working out 20 seconds a day, but then take a look at me. I think this is in shape. Also, hers is $39.95. Mine was...
Well, it's included on this.
It's a, yeah, hell, it's less than $19.95. So originally it was priced at $15.95, then it went down to $10.95, $5.95, and I believe now they'll pay you to take it out of the store. So you might look around for that. So, and you know, I'll tell you what hurt sales on my workout video. The Karen Ann Quinlan workout tape. She had hers was 20 minutes, and the goal was to turn over in your bed. She had, spindly leg warmers on. It was unbelievable. And, act like you're shocked by this.
I am.
This is the man who sent her hollandaise sauce for her birthday. Because she was a vegetable. Here's the workout
tape. I'm not laughing under this beard. No, I'm not.
Hi, gals. And thanks for buying the Steve Dahl video workout tape.
Hey, wait, stop the exercise tape. I forgot to embody one of the segments they saw in the It's Too Early montage.
Which one?
With my props.
Which segment?
The mime segment. So, could you hold these for me? He did white face, I'll do white butt.
Oh, no, this is not going to be
on... This might shock you.
This is not going to be on the X-rated shelf. This is going to be on the PG shelf, so we can't show...
Get out of the way!
We can't show this.
Get out of the way!
Can't show this.
Get out of the way!
Can't show it.
Tilt the camera down!
Hi, gals. And thanks for buying the Steve Dahl video workout tape. Time now for exercise number one. Hop up on the TV, won't you? Right in the middle there, that's perfect. Ready? Begin. Pretty grueling workout, isn't it?
Call me Mr. Prop.
I'd rather call you a hemorrhoid sufferer.
No, it's just a prop.
Sure
I have
is.
No roids.
No.
Couldn't you tell from that butt shot? Here, you want back-to-back crack?
No, I...
Huh? I won't do it. Don't worry.
So you...
Agile.
I've been watching you for the last few minutes, like a young Bob Keeshan.
You've been watching me ever since I pulled my pants down. Admit it.
That's how you look like a young Bob Keeshan. Don't you see him as the Captain Kangaroo of the 1990s? I do.
And who are you, Mr. Cream Jeans?
And now let's go over to Grandfather Cock. Let an old man...
Hello, Captain.
Let old man...
Pull your pants down.
Why do we do that? Bring the kids back. Come on, I'm sorry.
Scummy Rabbit. Mr. Goose. Mr. Moose Goose. Hey, that could be like a whole little parody we could do for the next home video.
Sounds good.
If there is one.
What's next?
And, we, you know, you never know in this business. It's such a topsy-turvy kind of thing. And,
if he can use a television term...
Topsy-turvy?
Yeah.
And let's face it, our projects, if I can use another television term, have not been well received. The exercise video sold only to my family because Garry was not in it. I got Wise on the Wimp video and put him in it and sold some to his family, but he wasn't in it that...
I wasn't in it that much.
Thank you. And...
and he stutters when he thinks about it, doesn't he?
When I think about all the money I've lost in this business.
Okay, Mel Tillis,
didn't
what's next?
Didn't Captain Kangaroo stutter?
Yeah, when they canceled him. What?
Imagine that. He's in the big coat, the big pockets. Hi, good morning, CBS executive.
He walks
Get
in
the
there.
Fuck out of here, asshole.
He comes back later with Mr. Green Jeans. They beat the shit out of these CBS executives.
Machine guns. Come here, you son of a... All right, you scum. The captain.
They're holding grandfather clock as a battering ram.
No!
Oh, just the thought.
Okay,
What's next? Cable show.
Yeah. And to go back to what we were doing before, it would be The Pleasure House.
The
kind
Pleasure
of a whole
House, yeah.
Pornographic Captain Kangaroo thing. Next, we did a cable show that was on for 13 weeks in Chicago, was canceled because it was no good, and nobody saw it because they don't have cable in Chicago.
Oops.
So why did we do a cable show?
Are we stupid or
what? We're just stupid, I guess. But here's something from that.
Stan, you see, it's not true. White guys are big, too. Big Log. Stan said Robert Plant wrote a song about me. Actually, he did say Prant, because he's part Chinese. Okay, this is a nice little outfit. I bought these all a little tight. Because they're not for me. You know, that's... the funny... I did buy them tight, because, you know, I thought I'd lose some weight before I went to Hawaii.
That is really hugging your,
Yeah. And, you know, I'll tell you, if I had a dollar for every time I heard somebody in the that big and tall men's store go, well, I'm going to be losing some weight soon. It's like 800 fat guys in there buying clothing that looks like tents. Well, I'm on a diet. I'm going to be losing some weight soon. I'll buy it a little tight. And the guy's going, yeah, right. But look, I bought it a little tight.
Yeah,
I couldn't sit down if I wanted to. But I look hot.
Yeah, look.
Look, it came out again. Oh, this is terribly embarrassing. I should have worn a jock or something. There you go, Letty.
Steve,
a little souvenir. Take it home to the wife.
That is the
cheapest.
I've
heard she wants one.
Lowest joke. I mean, in show business history, man.
Let me have it again.
I saw Myron.
Oh, it got out again.
I saw Myron Cohen do the same bit down at the Fountain Blue.
All right.
Stan, where do your eyes focus when you're back there?
Wherever he wants.
On that big log, buddy.
Oh, we've got a beef log back here from Hickory Farms of Ohio. We'd like to thank them for sending it. We have shoes?
Yeah.
Well, these white shoes are fine for now. I don't think we got enough time to do the whole thing.
Oh, geez.
I'll put this on. Why don't you get me jacketed up?
So this is your favorite outfit that you got down there?
Yeah, I think so. Janet says it's too loud. But I don't agree. I think you'll like it, Garry. I think you're going to wish you had one.
I think so.
All right. I think I look like I just walked off the set of Miami Vice.
Okay.
As a pimp, probably.
Can we have a drum roll? Let's get a drum roll.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. All right. It's a new look for me.
Again, you got the pants a little tight.
No, these pants fit great. All right, we'll be back in just a minute. Don't go away.
You know, you're really starting to disgust me with all these little antics, the Emmy in front of your crotch and the toilet paper in your shorts and now the panties on your head.
What about the butt show? Don't forget the butt show.
How can we forget the butt show? You're starting to disgust me here.
I'm sorry. I guess that these are cheap visual gimmicks, but... Doesn't it kind of look like a goalie mask?
Goalie Hawn.
How about this? I'll be a spray painter. I was just going to give like a household hint. If you're going to be spray painting and you don't want to buy an expensive mask, because they're like $1.50 or something... Just get a pair of your wife's panties. I like to get them right out of the hamper, you know, but...
You're really starting to wear thin on this,
put them on your face. Or how about this? I'm Prince. Purple rain! Purple rain!
But that's a different video.
Right. Now back to ours. We're out of the television thing. Fuck television. We're too good for it, right?
Yeah.
So now we're into motion pictures. And here's the trailer from our upcoming film. Hi, Steve Dahl.
And Garry Meier.
The proud owners of the rights to the Garry Dotson, Kathy Kroll web story. Nobody else wanted them. They thought they did. Paramount, Universal, Columbia. They were all bidding for the rights to the story, but when it ended the way it did, with Governor Thompson saying that Garry is, as far as he's concerned, a convicted rapist and did rape Kathy Kroll Webb and that she lied about her recantation, well, you know, it doesn't really have a Hollywood ending.
Yeah, a pardon was not granted, so.
No, so the ending was not that appealing. Major studios and Garryotrope studios purchased the rights for $35. And we'd like to show you now just a small part of the major motion picture that we're making about the Garry Dotson, Kathy Kroll Webb story. And we think you're gonna like it.
I'm sure they're gonna like it.
God, I hate working at Long John's. I always smell like fish. And you know, for me, with my immaculate hygiene, I just hate smelling like fish. That's why I shower every day. Today I hit my head on the freezer. I've got a giant goose egg on the back of my head. A giant 5-gallon tartar sauce drum blew up in my face. I hate getting that stuff in my face. It reminds me of sex with my boyfriend, David Byrne. God, I just hate my job and my life, I swear. I've got to do something to change my life. I'm just so sick of the way things are going.
Hey, look at that. Hey, she's hot. Hey, baby!
Hey, you rowdies, cut it
out!
Let's
get that.
You're scaring me.
Two points. Let's get it.
Hey, cut it out, you rowdy guys!
Hey, baby! Hey!
Cut it out!
Get her.
What do you guys want, anyway?
Hey, my friend thinks you're a fox.
What's your name?
Huh?
Kathy.
You want to go for a ride with us?
No.
Well, how about if I give you this TV?
No.
How about if I give you this compact disc player?
No.
How about if I give you this cigarette?
Okay, you've got a deal.
All right, you're hot. Hey. Yeah, baby.
What are you doing?
You're hot.
This is a nice car.
You're hot.
What's your name?
My name is Garry.
Garry?
Yeah.
Hey, what are you doing?
Want to get into some action?
You just shot your whipped cream up my dress.
I'm sorry, baby.
Hey,
you're so hot.
Cut it out. Take that whipped cream out of my... Hey, look,
you got whipped cream
all over my panties.
Baby, you're hot.
What am I going to tell my mom? What am I going to tell her? She hates it when I get whipped cream on my panties. What am I going to tell her?
Tell her there's a movie in it for her.
What am I going to tell her? You're supposed to say, tell her you got raped.
Tell her you got raped.
We can't do this over now because you've squirted whipped cream all over. You've squirted whipped cream all over everything.
Can we edit?
Well, yeah, but then I have to go take a shower now. You've got whipped cream all over everything.
I can't hold it, baby. You're too hot. God, you're hot.
Tell her you got raped.
Tell her you got raped.
Okay, that seems like a good idea.
All right, baby.
Knock it off with the whipped cream, you schmuck.
Yeah, you like having fun, don't you?
Stop it, you guys.
You're
getting whipped cream all over me. My mom's going to kill me.
You like this, don't you?
Stop. Stop.
Now get out of here. Get out. Get out. Get out.
God, you guys are so mean.
Get out of here.
How am I going to explain this to my mom?
Let's get out of here.
Oh, this is the worst day of my life. Well, I guess it's safe to come out now. They've been gone for a couple hours. I hope. Tell my mom I was raped. Tell my mom I was raped. If she finds out it's whipped cream in my panties, she's gonna kill me. This has turned out to be a god-awful experience. I wish some nerdy guy would come by and marry me. Hey!
God, you look pretty.
Thank you.
Pretty awful. I'm sorry.
Who are you?
I'm David Webb.
I love you.
You want to get married then?
Okay.
Get in. Oh my God.
Well, that's our video cassette.
I think that's going to be a big movie. I think we have got something
you
there.
You know, it was only an hour, but it seemed longer.
Yeah.
I mean, we've grown mustaches since the beginning of the...
Some of us on our fingers. That's how long
video
it's been.
Cassette. We hope you enjoyed it. Hope it was worth $19.95. If it wasn't, don't try and take it back, because that would be cheating, wouldn't it? Because you've already seen the whole thing.
That's right.
And don't, under any circumstances, duplicate it.
Don't.
Because I will find you, okay? Because there's a special secret electronic thing encoded into the tape, and I know if somebody's making a copy.
That's right.
And I will find you, and I will do things to you that will make Joseph Mengele look like a choir boy. Do you understand me? Okay? Fuck the FBI. You're gonna have to deal with me. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.
I'd like to end on a Rambo chant, if we could.
I think that's a little too dated, don't you?
It's the biggest movie in history.
Yeah, but not everybody knows what a Rambo chant is.
We're going to do it, I thought.
Right now?
Yeah.
Let's just do it. How do you do it?
Woo! Rambo!
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 Rambo!